you come back and you can check that now when you hit your ELB link, you have access forbidden. Okay, so that's amazing, guys. Hello guys, hope you all doing good. In today's videos, we are going to provision our infrastructure following this diagram. And after the infrastructure will be provisioned, we have our EC2 instance running and serving traffic. We are going to configure our WAF web application firewall and set the rules in order to filters and block malicious requests. Okay, so in order to do so, the first step we will do is, yeah, we have our infrastructure, we have our VPC, we have the availability zones, the load balancer, the NAT, and the auto scaling group. So all these different resources will be provisioned using Terraform, okay, infrastructure as a code. So we're going to define that one after the other. And at the end, we are going to have an output that will serve us traffic to the load balancer. Okay, so let me present you the code that will help us do that. So I'll just provide the link in the description. You can view that. So first of all, we have the providers. In order to configure our providers, we need to write this code. Here I have the providers for Terraform and the provider for AWS, which is in the VAR region where I define it later. And I have also defined my remote state here. Okay, so I have also my VPC where I name my VPC demo VPC, and I have the different subnet defined where I will allocate. It should be public subnet 1 and 2. So I have all that following up the main structure that is being on the diagram. Okay, so aside the subnet, we obviously need an internet gateway in order to have access to the internet. So I define my internet gateway as this, and I give it some tags for demo app and internet gateway as name. And after the internet gateway, we naturally need to have the routes. Okay, it's the routes table that it's in the routes table that we are going to define the different traffic flow between the different subnets and the internet. Okay, here we are in the public route table. So we create the route tables and associate them for internet access. Okay, everything being done, we have a route table that will give access to the internet. And now we need to have another file, nat.tf, where we create the elastic IP for the first subnet, and we do that twice. And aside those elastic IP, we need to create the NAT gateway that will use those elastic IPs in order to provide access to the internet, since we will obviously have a private subnet which will use those NATs. Okay, so within our private route table, we will define the route tables and associate that to the various NATs gateway. Okay, we have different blocks of code that enable us to do that, as you can see. Okay, everything being defined correctly, we go to the next file where we obviously need to define the security group and the policy, whereby within the security group for the load balancer, we will allow traffic on port 8080 on protocol TCP, description HTTP, with the CRD block on out to internet. And we also need to have a security group to allow access to the web server, okay, which will define, which we will allow port 8080 and port 20. Okay, everything being done correctly, we will naturally need to have like
a launch configuration. So the launch configuration will enable us to launch the instance, okay? And with this instance, we are going to provide the different resources, and the launch configuration will need to run script, okay? Yeah, I have the init web server script that is in another file that will present later. So aside the launch configuration, we need an auto scaling group, okay? It's in the auto scaling group resource where we will define the desired capacity, the maximum capacity, and the minimum capacity that we want as number of instance, okay? We also define the keep that is going to be using, and aside that, we create a target group, okay? Now, obviously, what enable us to have access to all these resources, we're going to hit the load balancer, and with this load balancer, we need to create the resource. Here is the code, okay? So that being done, with the load balancer reaching out to our EC2 instance, we will be having to run this code in our web server. So when the web servers will start, or when the auto scaling group will launch the configuration, this is what will happen in the background, and at the end we are going to have an output of hello from the host name or the IP of the server, okay? And after executing this whole code, we will obviously have to trigger it using a link, okay? That will be on output. And aside that, we need to define the region in which we'll be working on. I do that in the terraform.tf var. And at the end, we define all our variables file in the variable.tf, where you have the key pair, the Amazon machine image. We also have the different subnet address that we define in this resource. Okay, everything being done correctly with the security groups, everything correctly set, what we need to do now is, first of all, run an initialization of a file. So now you can see that I have no instance running. I have my key pair as prerequisite, okay? Once you've edited all these variables corresponding to what is in your infrastructure, you can come into your command line, place yourself within the correct directory, and hit Terraform init, okay? I initialize my environment, I initialize my backend, and you first need to create your backend using S3, or you can have a backend locally if you don't want to do that remotely. Okay, once the Terraform init is good, the next command you hit is Terraform apply auto approve. Okay, this will obviously run a Terraform plan in the first step, and we will have all the resources that will be created. So this is done in order not to do the approval letter with yes. Okay, so you just give it some time, and here we can see that I have 24 resources that are planned to be created. Okay, I will just give some time, and the resource will be created, and at the end, we will have an output. Okay, give it some time, some few minutes, and everything will be up and running. Okay, everything going. We can see that we have the NAT gateway resource that have been created. All the resources have been creating. Everything is nice. Okay, at the end, we have apply complete resource, 24 resource added. Here we have demo ALB TF followed by a random number. And okay, we can use this link or this output and try to hit it in order to view what is happening in our instance. Okay, depending on what we provided in the init web server script. Okay, so for now, I just do an update. I still have my resource created
if I open this link, you see that there we have the load balancer, and here we have our instance that have now been provided. And now we can see that with the link I copied previously, since the instance haven't yet been initialized, we can access that. So it is not yet up and running. So you need to give it some time, and you hit back the link, and we are going to have that result. Okay, here we see that we have our auto scaling group, that is the status isn't yet up, so give it some time. And we can see that we have a desired capacity, minimum capacity, maximum capacity, so everything is being provisioned well as we define. You just need to give it some time for the different script to run through. Okay, so everything being done correctly, if we do an update here, in order to have a new status aside of the instance state that is already running, the initialization shouldn't be the same. Okay, guys, so I'm just allowing some time to be sure that everything will be okay. So now we can see that I only have one instance that has gone on initialization through, so now I can permit myself to hit the load balancer endpoint that I previously copied. And now I have hello from this IP address ending with 205, so everything is being done correctly. I only have one that is up and running, and if we check, it is the same IP address ending by 205. So that's awesome. So let me check the second address of the instance. I have it ending with 111. So let me try and update that. Okay, we see the load balancer plays its role and it distributes traffic once to the first subnet and the second to the second subnet, which are in different instance. Okay, so that's been done correctly. I think now we need to pass into the second phase. So the second phase will mostly consist of creating a WAF in order to filter the traffic. Okay, so in order to do that, you can go and hit the WAF in order to like block the public from accessing the instances that are being deployed within our resources. Okay, so let me do that in a new tab. Okay, I have the WAF interface, AWS WAF and AWS Shield. So I click on go to AWS Shield. Okay, here is what I have, but I think we don't have to work here. Let me go back on WAF and IP set. Yes, it is in the same region. Let me go on WAF and IP set. I first of all create an IP set. Okay, you can give it the name that you want. Let me just place mine, my IP set. Okay, and a description that goes in the same way. So once you have a description that explicitly says what our WAF will be doing, okay, we will also need to give an IP address, like for example, to allow permissions for our WAF. Okay, I just paste the IP address of one instance followed by /32. Okay, for the network. Okay, click on create. Amazing. that's done concurrently. Good. Okay. So the next step after the IP set done, you can go around and go up to web ACL access control list, and you create one right up top right. Let me give it a name similar to my web ACL. Okay. And a description that goes into the same way. Okay, you make sure you allow regional resource where you have all the different type of resource that will be defined, including our application load balancer. And now I add the resource, which type of resource I want to add application, and I select the application load balancer I'm wishing to go with. So once that done, I click on next. Now I need to create a role. Okay, you go on the role, add role, and manage role and group. Okay, add my own role and group. Okay, once that done, since we are working with IP set, you go on IP set and you give the role you want to work with. Okay, give it a name, and after the name, I'll name mine my web ACL role. I select the IP set I'm wishing to work with. Okay, everything been done correctly. Yes, keep it on source IP. I wish to block traffic. Okay, so you can scroll down if you want to enable a personalized output when the web traffic you are blocking is being applied. Okay, so everything done correctly on that side. I now hit on next. Okay, next will be set role property. I just select my web ACL role I just created in order to block traffic. Okay, and I hit the next. Okay, you leave it as default. You hit next, guys. Now you go through everything. Everything set correctly as we expect. So now you can verify that my resource, my, I come back. I now create my web application firewall. ACL. No, yeah, I'm creating the just give it some time. You give it some time, and you come back and you can check that now when you hit your ELB link, you have access forbidden. Okay, so that's amazing, guys. So you can go through your different resources, you hang around, you try to see like what are the different things you can do. Now the access is being forbidden, like you can open back the access. If you to do that, you need to, like, instead of block, you allow the web ACL. Okay, I have that allowed. I give it some time. Okay, it's forbidden. I leave it some time for propagation. While waiting for the propagation to go through, you can just navigate around everything, see how the different parameters are. Okay, and okay, I have an overview. Okay, so yeah, it's a kind of view about the request that were being made. Okay, just 21 seconds ago. Okay, that being done, I can hit back and now everything is open.